When Tower of God first came out, I was a big fan of it. It's a world filled with mystery, characters that seemed interesting despite us just seeing the surface, and a story that slowly but surely drew me in. I made a first impressions video where I compared it to Hunter x Hunter, saying how it could be the next Hunter x Hunter. Though I ended up putting Tower of God on hold at that point, not really wanting to watch something like that weekly. But I recently got back to it, finished it, and well, it was interesting, that's for sure. It's also really hard to judge, because we've only seen season 1. And despite the fact that a season 2 has not been announced yet, I'm pretty sure we'll get it, so I'm going to assume that we will get more. Though, while the webcomic creators say that it gets better, and I don't doubt them, my belief is that season 1 needs to be enjoyable enough on its own to warrant me wanting to watch more. I'm not going to watch more of something if what I got so far is bad. But rest assured, I do believe Tower of God is a good show, though not without its flaws. The premise of the first season is the test the characters have to go through to advance to the next floor of the tower, with the promise that if they reach the top, they will find whatever it is they are searching for. Most of the time spent on these tests, though, that's actually not the focus of the show. Instead, the focus is on the characters, getting glimpses at what makes them tick. A lot of the characters are really fun too, like Coon and his bag of tricks, or Rack loving chocolate and calling the humans turtles. And I liked Anak and Endorsi once I understood more what they are after. Bam, though, despite being the main character, is kind of unremarkable. He starts off not knowing anything about the world, only having his desire to find Rachel, but throughout the season he makes friends and really values this friendship he has with everyone. Kind of typical for a main character, but you know, I like this cliche in anime, so I won't complain much. Rachel, though, the character that Bam is going after, is probably the most interesting one of the show, and I want to see more of her. She kept her distance through most of the season, though by the end we got to see some of the events from her perspective, which I found to be really fascinating, especially seeing how she feels about Bam and herself. I understand why some people don't like her. I get it. In some ways, I agree. But it is for these reasons that she is a really fascinating character. When it comes to the story itself, I didn't care for it all that much, beyond the character exploration I've already mentioned. I've heard that the anime goes through the manga very quickly, and it shows by how events are covered. Story beats are just sped through, and while I mostly understand what happened, some of the events just don't feel like they have the same impact they do. Or we just get stuff glossed over like Shinsu, or how things are working with the points, or just a lot of things about the world itself. I do appreciate the smaller looks we get into the bigger conflicts, like what is going on with the princesses and the royal family, but so far we're only getting very small pieces of it, so there's not enough to get into, though I hope we do see that more in season 2 and or later seasons. One of the ideas I really found interesting was how characters react to having companions stronger than them. Many of these characters are super strong, while others are more ordinary, and seeing all of these amazingly powerful people is disheartening to the more normal ones. So it was really fascinating to see how they reacted, and I'm curious to see where the show will take this idea later on. Animation-wise, I liked it quite a bit. I liked the bright colors and just the whole style here, plus the action looked cool, so overall very fun, very modern-looking in a good way. I enjoyed the music as well too, like how it had the unconventional music for the fights. There were other parts where it was less standout, not bad, but also not amazing. The English dub here is really good. The voices sounded so natural that when I decided to try the dub, I actually forgot that I was listening to it in a different language until like halfway through it I noticed when the characters sounded different and I was like, why do they sound different? Oh wait, different language. So that just shows how natural the dub is, so props to all the voice actors. I also appreciated how the opening and ending were in English for the English dub, which that really fits. It's kind of weird when you're watching a show in English, but the music for the beginning and end isn't. So it is a nice touch that they could do that. But speaking of that, I love the opening and ending here, and I'm now a fan of Stray Kids. I wish they had more songs in English, though. Levanter is great, though. I listened to that while making this video. There are fireworks outside. That or thunder. Happy 4th of July, everyone. So yeah, overall, Tower of God, a solid show. In my first impressions video, I said it reminded me a lot of Hunter x Hunter, and looking at it now, it still kind of does. Not just in quality, but there's a similar feel here. though I need to see more of Hunter x Hunter since I'm only on the Hunter exam arc. Maybe that's what I'll do next. Though I also want to get caught up on Fruits Basket. And my friend just told me to watch Snafu. I don't know. Tell me which of these I should watch. Leave a comment down below, because comments are good for the YouTube algorithm. And then subscribe too, because I promise when I do get to more Hunter x Hunter, I will be making videos on it. Probably do like a video for each arc. Regardless, thank you for watching this video and listening to my rambling, and I will talk to you next time.